Who remembers having fun on Warzone recently? Isn't that just a crazy concept that a game is so divided that you either join the meta or just not have fun within Verdansk? I was playing last night with Special Service, and we were just trying to not use meta weapons for as long as we could. But every time someone had an AUG or the FFAR, we would just get smoked so fast. And we were sitting there thinking, whoa, my apologies for not using a meta weapon and expecting to win gunfights. But honestly, if you try to use any weapons off meta, you have to change your playstyle to be able to win gunfights, which sucks because a lot of people like rushing into buildings, but when the team you're rushing has FFARs and AUGs posted up waiting for you to come through a door, you could come through with the LC-10, Bison, anything in the world, and you're just gonna get smoked. And what I've been doing recently within Warzone is I haven't even been going for wins. I've been playing with off meta weapons, just trying to figure out how to beat FFARs and AUGs as much as possible with using some of the weaker weapons in the game just so I become a better player. I feel like I've been using the meta so much it's made me become a weaker player because I have to rely on the FFAR and AUG. So recently, I haven't been going for wins, I've just been going for high kill games with using off meta weapons and have been trying to improve my game skill. But every time I play Warzone, even when I'm doing this, I'm still getting melted by FFARs and AUGs, and it's very demotivating to play. And I remembered that Rebirth Island was a thing, and the weekly game mode for Rebirth Island was Duo's Resurgence, and that's just standard battle royale but with no gulag. And the way you come back is you either get bought back or your teammates stay alive for the required time for you to respawn, which I think is like 25 seconds from the time that you're dead to when you come back. So your teammate literally just needs to stay alive, which can be hard at the beginning of the game of Resurgence Duos on Rebirth just because it's so hectic. But if you can survive that initial wave of just enemies, you're pretty much set for the entire game. Loadouts only cost 7,500 in this game mode, and money spawns in high amounts, so loadouts are extremely easy to get. Also, there's only 40 players, which I don't know if that's meant to be a thing, because usually I thought it was like 60 to 80 players on Rebirth Island, but this game mode's 40. So if you survive that initial wave, there's only gonna be like 20 people left in the game that you have to deal with on a huge map. So you have tons of time to loot and get all your stuff together, and no one runs Ghost either, so you can pop those UAVs and just see where everyone is. The downside is when people are camping on the roofs that are inaccessible unless you push them, knowing that they're gonna kill you because they're watching the one entrance point to that roof. So it becomes a race to who can get their loadout the fastest and get the high ground where there's only a few or one access points, and then hold that high ground until the zone cuts everyone off. And you can totally survive being on ground levels too. You'll see a gameplay of me and Special Service winning duos when every team but us had the high ground, and it does get slow in late circles depending on where the zone goes. If the zone's out in the open, the games go very fast, and they can take like 5 minutes to complete an entire game, which is crazy because you never expect a battle royale to be that quick. But what's great about this game mode and how fast it goes is even if you end up dying right off the start or die in second place, it's so easy to just drop in and reset, unlike Verdansk, because sometimes in Verdansk it takes like 5 minutes to get set up and have all the score streaks and the loadouts and all the equipment and field upgrades that you want for the rest of the game. But within Resurgence Duos on Rebirth Island, you can land and be set up in 30 seconds to a minute, and then the rest of the game you can just run around and play and have fun, which is such a refreshing experience, at least for me. And even in Resurgence Duos, I'm still running non-meta weapons. I was running the Bison, or I guess that's called the Bullfrog, and the RPD yesterday. Yes, there were times where I was getting absolutely melted by AUGs and FFARs, but I feel because the low player count and then just the way that the map of Rebirth Island plays, you don't have to rely on the FFAR and AUG like you do in Verdansk. I don't know if it's just the sweatier players are on Verdansk and the more casuals are in Rebirth Island, but it was just so refreshing to hop in there and play this. One thing that you will notice is the player count drops really fast, and a lot of people die right off the beginning and get kicked out of the game. And since there's no gulag, once your team gets wiped, you have no chance of coming back. Yes, you do spawn in with a self-revive, but once you're out, and then you have to re-queue up into a new game. So the player base drops really fast within a game, and you go from 40 players to 25 extremely fast, and then 25 to the top 10 almost within the first 2 minutes of the game, which does cause some issues where the game will be a little bit slower because you expect people to be everywhere, because if you've played Rebirth Island in any other game mode, or if it's trios or anything, there's people everywhere and there's always action going on. But when you're in top 10 situations and half the map is still in play, it does tend to slow down, which does give you time to loot and set up. But if you're just running in to run and gun and trying to get as many kills as possible like we were yesterday, there was times where it was just really weird and really slow. And our first game ever, we were looting and getting our loadout done, and by the time we had our loadout, there was no joke, five people left in the game, and they all died, and we only ended up seeing like two squads that game. The one squad that landed with us and we had our initial fight with, and then the second squad was literally the exact last squad that we killed to win the game. So you will get weird anomaly games like that where you load out and get set up, and then all of a sudden there's like a couple people left in the game. I've only seen that twice out of around the 20 games I've played, but it can happen, and it's very odd when it does, because once again, you expect people to be absolutely everywhere and to be getting shot from 500 angles, but it's very weirdly calm in games like that. The only thing that's super hectic in the game is final circles. If there's three or four teams left, when the circles get really small, if there's a lot of buildings in zone, and then when the zone cuts everyone out of the buildings off, then you have three teams running out in the open and all fighting each other. And of course, at the very beginning of the game, Special Service and I have always landed biolabs regardless of what game mode we're playing on Rebirth. So we're super used to landing there. But whenever we're there, we always have three or four teams land with us, so we're fighting those three or four teams to be the last team alive and not get wiped from the game. And then the second you wipe those teams, and if you're the last team standing, then comes the tedious part of buying a loadout and then waiting for the zone to cut off all the hiders, people camping in buildings, while you're trying to run around and find enemies to shoot at. But in this game mode, and just the map in general, the positives outweigh the negatives by a lot, and I have so much fun playing in this. And I know Resurgence duos on Rebirth Island will get replaced by duo buybacks or trio buybacks or Resurgence or just other game modes, and I kind of feel bad that I only discovered this later in the week when the playlist was about to switch, and it's Tuesday when I'm making this video too, so by now it could have completely changed. But the fact is I'm having so much more fun on Rebirth Island than Verdansk. I usually will play a couple of warm-up games on Rebirth Island and then just go play normal battle royale in Verdansk and try to use those off meta weapons and improve my skill in the game. But for those who just are fed up with the Verdansk experience, remember, Rebirth is there. It's fun, it's fast paced, it's easy to jump into and just have a fun game. It's not as time demanding as Verdansk is, where you have to loot and do contracts to get your loadout really fast. And then once you're done that, you want to get your self revives, and then you want your equipment and score streaks. But on Rebirth Island, it's a much more watered down experience where you don't have to rely on a lot of the things that you would have to rely in Verdansk, because it's a way bigger map. All you have to worry about is killing the teams that land with you and either wait for your loadout drop to come in or buy it yourself. And then once that's done, within the first minute, you're just off to the races and having fun and focusing on the gameplay at hand rather than trying to complete objectives or contracts. Now, there are contracts on Rebirth, but they don't take main stage like they do for looting within Verdansk. And there's a lot of people that constantly play Rebirth Island over Verdansk, but this is just a reminder. If you're grinding Verdansk like we are, if you want a break but still want to play Warzone, this is still here at our disposal, and hopefully we will have cool game modes coming to Verdansk in the future, like buyback solos, buyback trios. It's been a while since we've had those kind of more party game-esque Warzone game modes, and recently Warzone has just been super sweaty and super tryhard recently, and thankfully I was reminded that this was a thing. Leave a like if you did enjoy, dislike if you didn't. There's no hard feelings if you didn't. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys have been doing to have fun in Warzone to inspire others to not use the FFAR constantly. Anyway, subscribe for more videos in the future. Check the description for my Discord link, which is at the top of the description. And yeah, with that being said, I'm about to head out. And if there is one, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.